really happened to the stingrays at the Calgary Zoo, because I know that was a big like discussion on the media a couple years ago. And are zoos good or bad? So what happened with the Calgary Zoo was, when it opened up the new stingray exhibit, I think after a couple months they noticed that there was some strange black spots on a lot of the stingrays, and a lot of them were dying. So yeah, as you can see, 41 out of 43 count of stingrays died. And what they think happened was that an oxygen pump going into the water failed, and as the stingrays started to deteriorate, the zookeepers noticed something was wrong and came and splashed around trying to catch some of the stingrays so they could figure out what was wrong. As they did that, they put more oxygen into the water, so when they checked to see if the oxygen levels were okay, it looked like everything was okay. So as it was a hot day, so as it got hotter, water loses its ability to retain oxygen, so there was just less and less oxygen in the water and the stingray was done. So zoos are good because they provide a safe environment for animals. There's no predators to kill them, and there's no environmental factors that could kill the species off. It also educates people about the importance of protecting animals. So I remember when I was really young, I really wanted to protect the animals and save the animals. And it's also an opportunity for research. So at zoos, we can research animals without invading their natural habitat. So zoos are bad because some enclosures may be to please the public, not to protect the animals. Like, I was reading a story about an elephant in Alaska named Maggie, and because it's so cold, for most of the year she had to hang out in a little enclosure like this. Sometimes they can't provide some of the resources animals need, like zebras and a lot of animals that live in the savannah. They need more space than just a couple acres of land. Like, again, going back to the elephants, they travel almost 30 acres a day in the land, and they're really lucky if they get only one. And studies show that visitors to zoo actually spend more time talking about other things beside the animals. So 80% of the time, visitors are talking about their life, their clothes, and not the animals. So these are just some perspectives on the stingrays. So the zoo veterinarian says, I feel that from an animal welfare standpoint, the zoo does an excellent job looking after the animals. And an organization called Zoo Check Canada, the executive director says, when the touch tank exhibit first opened, we expressed a variety of concerns. And like I said in my past slide, Zoo critics say such attractions are more about amusing the public and boosting gate revenues while ignoring concerns for the animals' welfare. So my opinion is that zoos are good when they're treating the animals in a humane way and are bringing animals in so that they can educate the public and maybe research their behaviors. And deaths of animals may happen from time to time from old age, but I don't think it's okay that, for example, like the stingrays, they all died at once because of failure. And I think they also provide a stellar learning environment for kids. Like, I really want to be a veterinarian when I grow up, partly because when I went to the zoo, I was always really inspired by what veterinarians do to help the animals. So what is Canada doing about zoo deaths? So charities and organizations like Zoo Check are promoting animal welfare in captivity and looking through zoos, making sure everything's okay. And Alberta has actually made some zoo regulations so that zoos need a permit, and if they don't comply with some regulations that they made, the zoo permit will be revoked. And after the stingray inspection, the Calgary Zoo is actually changing their qualification for employees, so something like this doesn't happen again. Thank you.